her fault. I could have gone through it before. Okay, we can start rolling now. Okay, aloha everyone. Aloha.
Aloha.
I love that. So we're here to talk about real exosome patients. And thank you for battling the traffic and, or not the traffic, the parking, and coming out to our lecture. It's going to be some of me talking, and it's going to be hopefully a lot of people in the audience who've gotten treatments. There are at least 10 people sharing as well. So this is what happens when you're on a hike and you fall 30 feet. This was 3 or 4 years ago. This lady, 48 years old.
Excuse me.
40 years old. And the only reason I bring this up is because there are, you know, I've treated over 50 patients now. Everyone is different.
Their histories
are different, and what happens when you take exosomes is also very different. So everything kind of leads to a block. She fell, and she came in with her brother. She really knew nothing about exosomes, so it's really more about trust. You know, they're very close growing up, and the brother, who's Hungarian, brought his business partner in 10 years. So they have done no due diligence. There's always one partner or friend or family member who doesn't really do the research. But if the relationship is good, they come in anyway. So, but they all had amazing results, all three of them. This was just about 4 weeks ago. What they each received was 6 billion IV exosomes. Again, that's not in her leg. That's not in the gentleman's intraperitoneal. Those are all techniques we have available. But the young lady, her legs started tingling and it experienced this heaviness, like a gravitas, which was interesting. And a lot of the twitching that we could describe and the kind of like pins and needles or ants crawling, I believe is new nerves generating. So that was interesting. So now she's actually running 2 weeks later, which is so happy about that. The leader who had talked to me for months, he actually, I went to him, so I thought I was a good doctor. I said, so be careful, because his thyroid was destroyed by radioactive iodine. So I said, you may have hyperthyroidism. He said, why? He said, because it might rescue some of your old thyroid cells. And in fact, that's exactly what happened. And he also had an improvement in his mood and his libido. Well, he's a 49-year-old gentleman. I think the most impressive was the third gentleman. And this is really, if you stay up late and watch TV, as I sometimes do, you look at this guy on the bottom. That's not Photoshop. That's 10 days later. It's really quite kind of a remarkable result. And it has an explanation. But he was the third guy. He knew nothing about exosomes. He came in, and he's so brilliant. He took three pictures, three different areas on his legs with varicose veins. 10 days, they were all gone. Now, if that's placebo effect, sign me up. Yeah. But the interesting thing is, he had this weird food intolerance. For the last 4 years, he hasn't been able to eat dairy. He hasn't been able to eat fast food or meat. He has 10 to 12 loose bowel movements. I guess you generally call it irritable bowel syndrome. And that resolved very quickly. So what you see on the bottom left is a 48-year-old man with a lot of histamine. He's swollen, food intolerance. And within 10 days, that's the same guy. He looks much younger, at least not as swollen. So astonishing results. Again, just 6 billion IV exosomes. Not to mention the varicosities, but his libido, and his quote was, I feel like 20 years old again, which was always very gratifying to hear. Another patient from November is an 86-year-old lady, and she had had 4 years of a rash, eczematous rash on her legs. And the cause of this, I later learned, was not atopic dermatitis. You know, a lot of people have atopic dermatitis. That's the itching that I have. You know, sometimes it's triggered by certain foods, and just like the Hungarian gentleman who looks so much younger. So it turns out that when your venous circulation is poor, I guess it's like you're not really emptying out your circulation. You get this eczematous rash. Well, interestingly, she took an IV injection, and 4 days later, we all noted that her feet were not purple and swollen. Initially, if you pushed into her feet, it would go in a centimeter and stay there. Very swollen, very poor circulation. So what ended up happening, after the 4 days, the feet were no longer swollen. And then after several weeks, the rash went away permanently. So that's what we call stasis dermatitis from poor circulation. Again, you know, it's just an interesting thing that happened, but it would be hard to evoke a placebo effect for that. I think one of the reasons I came, many of you know I came last week because Akimi fell again. Akimi is a wonderful giver and she's an enabler. Some would say codependent, but she just gives too much. She's like Oklahoma, the girl that can't say no. So she has done so much for me. And so when she said, I fell again, my arm was tingling last week, I said, well, I'm going to have to come out there early. So we came out early. And what happened was, back in November, she had fallen on her head, this house that was kind of cursed, tried to kill her. So she did one of these banana peel things in the cartoons. And at that time, she got what's called military neck. So if you see on the left, a lot of times when you strain your neck or get whiplash, you get this straightening of the cervical lordosis, which is the backwards curvature. And that was causing spondylolisthesis, or the vertebra are not lining up in the correct way and causing numbness down her arm. So the interesting thing is we gave her the IV exosomes, and I think that resolved pretty quickly. Another thing that we all noticed, friends like Terrell and Mary Lou, in that week where she hurt herself, she was kind of slurring her speech, having trouble finishing sentences, so I think there was some aspect of traumatic brain injury as well. So, and she also had some, I hope it's not embarrassing for you, but she had some dental problems, which improved too. We actually gave her 4 nerve blocks and injected all of the teeth, and that helped. So whenever a Kiwi calls, it's like a bad signal. I'm pretty sure we're going to have to fly to Hawaii and give her a treatment. So would you like to say any word about your treatments? I think you've gotten probably, 6 or 7. Wow. A Kiwi now, everyone.
Come on down. So lovely. Yeah, here.
Okay.
All right, so Luxury Homes International. You're buying or selling a home. Akimi's your gal.
So this thing is not working, but.
Is this hot?
That's not okay. Hot. You guys can hear me, right?
Yes.
Okay. So I had 6 shots nasally in my nasal. And when I had the fall, my neck, my whiplash went away within 24 hours. The pain went away. And then about 6 weeks, I think I was able to focus more and read a full novel, which I wasn't able to do before, because I'm always moving around and multitasking, which I don't think is very good for people. Can't focus and concentrate. And then I had an IV done. So overall, my second fall, tingling came back, and again, I did want to mention, about 3 months after I had all my treatments, a client ran into my, rear-ended my car, I was parked, so I had another whiplash on the right side. So I called the doctor, oh my God, I got this headache and my neck is all sore. But interestingly, within 3 or 4 days later, just disappeared. And I said, is the exosome still working? And he said, well, you know, I think maybe the body's getting younger somehow, and I'm able to sustain the damage. So to me, that was really amazing. And then I had another friend of mine. She fell down, and with all the exosome treatments, her injury, she fell on her face. And her injuries were minimal. She had a lot of bruising, but no broken bones. She's 85 years old. So I really believe this in this, the treatments that Dr. Park has been giving people. I've seen amazing results. So
I think that's about it.
Akimi Mallon, Luxury Homes International. What is it? She's a very good realtor. She'll do anything for you. She was even catering in a bed, sort of waiting tables. Right? Okay, so thank you for sharing that. Let's go to the next slide here. Those of you that have seen my blog may have seen Debbie. She's, again, somebody that knows me for many years. She was taking the TA65 telomerase activator. And she has some really interesting things to say. Some of the knees that we did, 4 of them are listed here. One of them is, I don't know, Stan Forster, did you make it? Oh, my man, okay, good. If you want to say something, we're going to have him come up. But I want to hear, I want you to hear what Debbie Baker says. She's got 3 injections already, IV, nasal. She couldn't do 1 squat at 65, and now she's 66. And 8 months later, she's doing 100 a day, every day, which is amazing, I think.
This is the video I made the night before I got my exosome shots as a before video.
I know, Pitchy Pitch.
As you can see, doing a squat was very difficult before exosomes.
Pop was my feet.
And also getting out of cars, getting out of a chair, getting out of bed, all of that.
Okay, here I am in the slowest elevator on the planet, headed for the city today to put my new bionic knees with exosomes to the test at the gym. So this will be fun.
It's only been a week since I had exosome shots and I'm already doing squats with weights. I could not do this before I had those shots. As an older woman, I'm very grateful to be able to add squats into my routine now.
My knees didn't hurt all that night or the next day, but the backs of my legs were very sore, and I think this is the exercise that might have done it. The last time I did these leg presses, it really caused my knees to hurt a lot, and I haven't done them in a long time. So I'm thrilled to be able to do this again to build up my legs a little bit.
So this was a real workout for my knees. I thought I would have some pain, but I didn't. So I continue to try to build strength in my lower body, and I'm very grateful to have this opportunity to do so.
So I'm really thrilled with my results, and I look forward to more exosome treatments. Thanks for watching.
I know there's J.M. is here, but I think he's a little shy, but he's one of those guys who last time I was here, 67, he got hurt during jiu-jitsu, tore his ACL, and they put a cadaver graft in. So, anyway, he was the one who wrote me, my left knee is better than my right now, so I think we're going to go ahead and do that again this week while I'm here. JB is here from New Zealand, and how's your knee doing, John?
Excellent. Mr. Berkheimer from New Zealand, thank you.
Actually, originally American, as you can tell by the accent, but I had an acute knee injury about 2 weeks before I came here, and I didn't come here with the expectation of any injury. I used to say to people, I'm so lucky because I've never had a broken bone. I don't have a pain, a joint issue, nothing. And so after I signed up, I emailed Ed about 10 days before and said, you better bring some extra product because I think I really screwed my knee up. So I don't know what I actually did to it. We didn't x-ray it, but it might have been a meniscus sprain, tear, whatever. At the end of the day, I was in here, unfortunately, for Mrs. Park declined to have treatment on her knee, and I jumped right in there at this conference and had it done. And I walked out pretty darn good, a little trepidation, but by the time we left, about 5 days later, I was fine, and it's completely fine now. So I'm a believer, but then again, I am a prophylactic healthcare nut. So everything from bioidentical hormone replacement to a 1-point HGH and everything else. So I believe, and I've been on TA65 for 11 years, and I believe in that sort of thing. And so people say, well, what's working for you? Well, when you do that many things concurrently, you really can't tell. You just knock on wood and say, it's fine. But the baseline for the whole thing, the common denominator for me is, even going back 30 years ago when I got on the HGH from a physician friend of mine, who was a doc that our family had known for a long period of time, my baseline is, if I'm doing bioidentical hormone replacement, if I'm doing TA65, if I'm doing this, my first question is to the doctor, do you do this yourself and do you do it for your family? And if the answer is yes, fine, I'll give it a shot. So Ed eats his own cooking, that's why I'm here.
John Berkheimer, all the way from New Zealand. Thank you for that. Ollie, you good? Everything good? Good. Okay, moving. We have also, I know that WZ, his wife is here. I don't know if she wants to say something. But, Elena quiere hablar. ¿Le da vergüenza? I can just say that she was introduced to a mutual friend, Rosa, who I know will come up and speak next. And her husband had some bad knees, osteoarthritis, getting old. So the pain went away. At first night it was 40, but it was bad. But after that, it got better and better. And now he's to the point where he doesn't feel like he wants a knee replacement anymore. So we're very happy and blessed about that. So he also is a person who wants to get another treatment. Stan Torser, ladies and gentlemen, linebacker from University of Hawaii. He was one of those defenders from Akini's fall. I was in here last week and said, hey, we've been talking for a long time. This healthy young man, how old are you, Stan?
64.
He's very strong. He had these extra long needles to treat his big shoulder and big knees. But he used to knock him down in high school and for U of H Rainbow Warriors. So tell us how you're feeling with your knee. You just got treated a week ago, right?
11 days. Yeah, 11 days ago. But the knees are doing really good. I mean, I can sustain. I do IH and OAA umpiring at the high school level. So I'm doing games with kids that are any place from 13 to 17 years old, 17, 18 years old. And that includes the full gamut. I mean, baseball is a very physical and running game. So, I mean, the last, when Dr. Park treated me, was about 7 days before I had to do a tournament with three games running right in a row, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday of last week. So I figured, he told me I should rest a little bit longer before I did that, but figured I'd try it out. I was surprised because it was like I was able to run, and I didn't even think, when I was running at full speed, chasing some 14-year-old kid down the baseline and trailing him onto the next base and second base, that's about 180 feet. There was no problem. It was like I never had the knee problem. So I mean, it's the only thing that I'm having right now is maybe psychosis because of the amount of activity that's been going through over the last week and is going to continue for the next like several months. It's a little bit tight, but you know, it's like tight from running, just from like a lot of activity.
How are your shoulders? A little bit.
Yeah, the shoulder. I had an ultrasound done about 2 weeks ago that said that I couldn't fit in the MRI machine, let's put it that way. So I couldn't do the MRI because I almost broke the machine. But anyway, when they took the ultrasound on my shoulder, the doctor said that I had like three tendons that were either detached or were cut free. So by right, I should be able to do pretty much anything of this nature. But I took the shot after Dr. Park gave me the shot. There was some, you know, there was some initial clicking like between the joint together, but I pretty much have almost full movement with no pain.
That's
okay.
Wow.
So whether the thing is severed or not.
Thank you so much, Dr. Forrester. Appreciate you. So again, you know, it's all about trust and who you know. You know, you got to know Stan, and like, is it worth it for me to make something up, for him to make it up? I mean, these are all paying customers, ladies and gentlemen. You have to imagine that they're all just here wasting their Oscar Sunday spouting BS to kick you out of your money. I think that's a little bit hard to believe. But Rosa, do you want to say anything at this point?
But how is your knee doing?
So what happened was, I came to see Dr. Park, and at that time I had just gotten a stem cell injection, and I went as part of my methodology. I went to prepare, so I saw Dr. Park. Dr. Park told me, "Well, I want you to do both knees." So I said, "Well, Dr. Park, I want to compare. So you just do my left knee. I'll call my left knee the exosome, and the right knee the stem cell." So the stem cell, I felt a little improvement. But then what happened with my left knee was after a few days, the pain started to decrease. And after a week, the pain was gone. And after another week, it was just getting stronger. Third week, I got stronger. But 4 feet, my knee felt like an Olympic knee. And I was back to heavy training. Thank you, Dr. Clark. I'm so happy to have received your treatment. And I hope that a lot of people can benefit by your exosome.
Thank you so much. Girls, have a great answer. Thank you. Question came up, am I aligned with a doctor here in Hawaii? Actually, because of a kidney stone, I applied and received my Hawaiian medical license, so I'm sitting as a Hawaiian medical doctor here. I'd like to turn now to a very common problem. It's getting near the break, so let's just, we're almost at the end. Back problems are very common. I don't know, did Tyler make it here? Tyler? Okay.
Thalia.
Thalia, my bad. Thalia is here. She was sitting next to Mom during the November show. And I don't know if she wants to tell us how she's feeling. I think it's a little better, maybe 30%. But if you don't mind, I'm going to show them your picture. And Wally's going to be next. So Wally is going to be next. Actually, let's go Wally first. He's 54. You met his lovely wife and his kids. He, at Iolani, where my son is currently a student, as a freshman, one of the assistants, Piper, flexed his neck and did a hairline fracture in his C5. He also, over the years of body surfing and working, had a herniated disc in L4, as well as a shoulder injury. So Wally took a few injections with Mom there, and right away there was this weird sort of energetic shift. Remember, he felt grounded, and he felt alive, and he tilted him upside down. So Wally E. Numa is going to say a little bit about his back pain and his shoulder. Next.
Okay. Wally.
So back in, I was a sophomore at Iolani, and it was my first year of wrestling. I didn't know nothing. This guy puts me in a position where my forehead touched my chest, and he held me in a position. So I went home, and I told my mom, well, you know, I got hurt today. And when I bent my neck in a certain way, I couldn't feel the pain. So the next day I went to a neurologist, we took an x-ray, and he said I had a fracture number 5. So he told me, let it heal, and let's see what happens next. So it took a month to heal, and the doctor gave me permission to go back to wrestling. So he told me just build the muscles. Okay. So I did a lot of neck exercises, and it was pretty amazing because nobody could pin me, but just because of the strength of the neck. So I was happy with that, but I lost a lot of matches because it was my first year. I started body surfing at the age of 12 at Sammy's. So I practically grew up there. And even after high school, I went there. And I stopped body surfing there in about 2012. I was lucky that I didn't really get hurt. But about 8 years ago, my neck started hurting. And I used to work for Andy as a diesel mechanic. And Sam was actually my boss. That's how we met. As a mechanic, we go into weird positions, and it's not really ergonomic. And I was experiencing pain from my neck down to my arms, and it'll just shoot, and it was sometimes painful. So I went to the doctor, I took an x-ray, and he said, oh, you got neck arthritis, because the spacing between the vertebrae are thinner than normal. So I decided to look into how to control the pain. So from 2009, I was drinking alkaline water, which is supposed to increase circulation. And then I went to chiropractors, acupuncturists. But it kind of, it wasn't like a permanent fix. And then in 2018, Akimi Mali introduced me to a biomat, which really helps control the pain. And then she introduced me to Dr. Park. I went to his first lecture in June of this past summer. There were 12 people. And at that time, I learned about the recharge and the exosome shots. So I had time to research about the exosome shots. And what caught my attention was that the exosomes regenerate cells. And that's what I needed. So I decided to get the shot. And on November 14th, he gave me a shot in the lower lumbar just because I had back pain before, but not really major kind. So given a shot, and he told me, lay down such that your belly button is higher than your head. He wanted the exosomes to go to the brain. So what happened is within 30 seconds, I felt grounded in that position, like, you know, your brain, the energy flow to your whole body. And then after 5 minutes, the chronic pain disappeared. And I was still laying inverted. So after 15 minutes of being in that position, he told me, okay, sit up. So I sat up and I felt my eyesight got a little better. And then I could feel the flow of the energy, but I had lost my pain. So from that time until now, what I feel is that the chronic pain disappeared. And because the pain disappeared, it has enabled me to do things that I couldn't do before, like mechanics. So just last weekend, we pulled out an engine. I was underneath the vehicle for about 2 days. But my neck really doesn't bother me anymore. So if anything,
Well, yeah, oh, yeah, no, you're doing great. The position is different too. You have a little bit of a military neck when we first met you too.
Yeah,
I know you injured your lumbar spine weightlifting in high school too, right? It was pretty bad.
Well, yeah, I had sciatica going on my left leg.
Yeah.
But so I'm both boxing and running around it, and then physical and posture improvement, everything feels lighter.
Yeah. I mean, he's in great shape, but like, I think there was just some chronic injury and misalignment. Yeah, much better. So you stripped your boat deck and all this, so no chronic pain.
Yeah, no chronic pain. If it comes back, it's like 1 or 2, but it goes away.
Great. Yeah, thank you so much.
Useful.
Thanks, Wally.
Thank you.
Okay. Wally, you know, everybody. So Talia was sitting next to my mom in November, and she has an amazing story, and she also works closely with one of the healers here. Come on up, Talia. She's 64, and she was water skiing, and it's amazing. Just jerked forward, and instead of let go of the rope, she went like this and jackknifed. And you can see here on this picture, above, it's a marshmallow. It's a beautiful cylindrical marshmallow, and below is the sacrum. But in the middle, it's kind of like a bidet, or like a unisex toilet. You see how the white rim is stopped, it doesn't go to the end. So the marshmallow got crushed. And so what happened was she was feeling a lot of pain and crunchiness. So she's going to tell you how that worked out for her. We did a lumbar epidural injection. And I just want you to appreciate how complicated the spine is. There's ligaments that decay. The disc is a multi-circular structure that decays. There's bones that articulate in cartilaginous joints. There's a lot that can go on in the back, and that's why a lot of people have back pain. But this was a very active Ms. DeMond. She crushed it in June, not in a good way. So please tell us what happened since then.
Yeah, so I had ongoing pain since June of last year from this unfortunate mishap. If you look about two-thirds of the way up, you see a little bit of white writing right there. That is where there's a bone on bone. And that is that between the L4 and the L5?
L4 and L5.
L4 and L5 right in between. You can see where they, where they're right resting on each other right there. So I'm just really lucky I didn't end up as a paraplegic from this accident. It was pretty scary. So my back was making these popping noises all the time. You know, just every step, just take a step, I feel a pop. Every step, there's a pop. And that went on for a couple of months, and so I got the x-ray in September. And then I was pretty shocked. And then I went to Marianne Wassel for Rolfing. It felt better, and then she invited me to your last visit here. And I had a few days later, Dr. Park did the injection right into that area. And I'm sure that all of you have an injection somewhere or other in your body at some time, but to think about having one in your spine is, you know, it's a little nerve-wracking, thinking, you know, is this going to hurt, or is it going to be make it worse? Because it's just, you know, there's just so much thick tissue and muscle around it, and I do stay in shape, and so I just thought, well, how do you even find that spot? So Dr. Park looked very carefully, studied the x-rays, talked to me, felt around in that area, marked it with a pen, and then did the shot, and it was fine. You know, it didn't hurt, it didn't really feel like there was anything going on right away. But since then, I guess it's been a couple of months, and Dr. Park, he texts me, and says, how you feeling, how you doing today? It's just the most amazing follow-up that you would ever have from a physician, so personal. And I would say that I'm between 30 and 50% improved, where I used to have this bone on bone with every movement. I'm now to the point where about at the end of a long day where I've had to lift and bend and pick things up, although I'm being a lot more careful than I ever was before about that, where I don't feel that in my spine until around 9 o'clock at night. Instead of starting first thing in the morning, get out of bed and I feel it in my back. So it's just been wonderful. I'm not planning to water ski again. It's probably not a good thing to do at the age of 64, although I haven't skied since I was 10, but not very often. You know, I just go to Arizona to visit family every year or two, and we go out on the boat and I ski again, and it's, well, I can still do this, it's amazing. But in this case, it was a mishap, and that's my spine there. It's pretty shocking to see that, and I just really am very blessed and fortunate that it wasn't worse, and then I got your help with it.
Thank you so much. It's possible that it would have gotten better, like this much or more, or this much or less. But you know, the fact that she's getting better, we're just grateful for that, because that was a pretty harrowing accident.
So I want to talk about nerves, and below that it says BDNF, that's brain-derived neurotrophic factor, and GDNF, which is glial-derived neurotrophic factor. These are a couple of things that in the second lecture, which we'll get to after the break, you'll see there's many, many specific proteins and messenger RNAs in there. One gentleman who couldn't come today, he was here at the November treat, the November lecture, and we were able to give him an intrathecal or intraspinal treatment. And luckily, well, not luckily, but you know, he had some return of movement and sensation, some involuntary movement. He was a T4, what we call Asia A class, meaning no sensation, no movement. So his goals and his aspirations are a little different. He just wants to get to the point where he can retain some function. Whether, you know, my friend Doug Spiel has the most experience, over 100 intrathecal injections. And he shows some amazing, you know, people with quadriplegia. But, you know, I think we need to back off and say, what is the best that we can hope for? I mean, maybe Talia would have gotten almost as good without the shot, we don't know. But the capacity to heal from a spinal cord injury is very limited, obviously. One of the blogs talks about my friend from Australia who had 4 years of chronic dental pain, and that went away overnight. Amazing. There had to be something, not just with inflammation, but with new nerve generation. I know Vicky, John's wife, and Deb with the knees, and Akimi all said, oh, I can read books now. And I didn't know that was a problem. I knew it was a problem with Oliver back there on his phone. You know, a lot of people can't focus in on the attention span, but I didn't realize that women don't read anymore. They love to read because they just can't focus. I think that's a human thing, maybe not a woman thing. So we talk about the nerves regenerating. I know mom, I always tease her whenever she makes a simple mistake, because she remembers all the patients that we treated. Although she didn't think Natalia's name was Karen, in all fairness. She kind of looks like a Karen, but she remembered everyone's history. She's like, how are they doing? How are they doing? So she's been a great assistant. But I think you've gotten like 4 nasal injections, and her memory is quite good now, and she's pretty on it. Anecdotally, I haven't had a lot of patients with frank Parkinson's or Alzheimer's, but I have heard good things. And like John said, I eat my own cooking. So when my son was back from break last month, I injected him because he said I'm having trouble focusing, I'm very anxious. So my older son, who's not here, 20 years old, he got an intranasal injection. And he texted me, says, best I slept in many months. We spent the day together, he was so calm. And I spoke to him yesterday, and he's still at a different level of functioning. So I think the take home lesson is that anxiety, depression, even maybe to extend autism, there's bad stuff going on in your brain and your body and you're inflamed.
So who knows what causes all that stuff.
So I want you guys to just enjoy, come and say hi, have some refreshments. The blogs, if you give us your email, I'll have the ability to send you these private blogs. I consider it kind of a semi-formal physician-patient relationship. You know, judge, buyer beware, read, but learn. You know, there might be some people in your lives who have problems with erectile dysfunction or shoulder problems, knee problems, plantar fasciitis. There's going to be a lot of great blogs coming up, and I do try and learn from patients. I think clinical experience is very important. I did go to medical school, did a full residency practice medicine. You have to be careful. I got an email from a gentleman whose dad is a doctor, and I think people with family members that are doctors, they have this sort of a halo effect. They think they can do stuff in medicine just because your husband or your... Anyway, so he did exosome injections, I think, on himself, and he had a reactivation of Lyme disease, which is a very predictable thing and treatable as well. But, you know, they say that someone who represents themselves improper in a court has a fool for a client or something like that. It's always better to get a second opinion. It's even better when that person knows a little bit about physiology. Also, some of the viral conditions can reactivate, so it's important to have some clinical expertise. I like to take a complete medical history, and, you know, we need to follow up. I'm always learning from what people are telling me. Everyone is different. If you want to make sure that these blogs go to you, you have to add me as a contact. So that's epark89@yahoo.com. Otherwise, I know a lot of people will get the emails, so they never actually get them because they're in the spam filter. So I think we're going to end it right there. Thank you, everyone, for who came up and spoke. And let's take a 15-20-minute break and come up and say hi. And afterwards, if you're so inclined, we can talk about why this exosome stuff might be worse. Thank you very much.